Hi, and welcome back to my OpenBIM with Revit video series. In our very first video, we already had a look at the IFC schema, and we also mentioned the common property sets, which contain the standardized information about every object in IFC. So today we want to have a look at how we export the common properties from Revit. First, let's have a quick look at the IFC documentation to remind ourselves what we are talking about. In the specification for every single entity, you will also find a list of the common property sets. For example, here for a wall. The good news is that these are already implemented in the Revit IFC exporter and will export automatically if they exist and are populated in Revit. Now, what do I mean by that? And why aren't all common IFC properties automatically included in Revit? Now, the IFC schema defines a lot of common properties which are not used in the most of the projects and would simply overload your Revit project with unnecessary information. Now, let me show you what I mean. I created a couple of walls which we will export and take care to activate the common property sets. This option is activated by default, but you can double check to be sure. After the export, you will see that we do have the property set, however, it is not showing all the properties we saw in the documentation. So how can we add these? The first option is very easy, but not always the preferred one because it forces you to use exactly the same naming as defined in the IFC schema. This means we can add the missing parameters either by using the shared parameters or by copying them from another file. We already practiced adding the shared IFC parameters in the second video as we talked about the project, the site and the building. So now I want to show you how you can copy these from another project. I have a blank project file as a template for my IFC properties. Here I can easily group them in a schedule and then simply copy and paste the schedule into my current project, which will automatically import the properties. Of course, it makes sense to add all the properties you use on a regular basis into the project template directly. After we add the properties, we can go ahead and fill these. I will leave some values empty on purpose and hit export. As you can see, the property set has now been completed. As already mentioned, only the properties with values will be exported to IFC, therefore the properties we left empty are not seen here. As you can see here, this is quite easy, but what can we do if we already have the properties inside of Revit and simply want to map the values onto the IFC common properties? This can be done using a parameter mapping file, which is a simple text file where you can list all your properties and associate them with the IFC properties. To show you this, let's start again with a clean file and add some German properties, which I want to map onto the standard properties. This actually happens quite often because the shared parameters you add to the project are different from the built-in parameters and won't translate automatically when you open a German Revit. So usually it is a lot easier to simply map the properties than to teach your Revit users funny terms like compartmentation or combustible. We just need to take care to use the same data type, which is also associated with the IFC properties, because of course we cannot map a yes or no parameter to a number. I can also freely choose between instance and type parameter as this won't matter for the mapping. There is no template for the parameter mapping file, so you can simply create a text file from scratch with three columns starting with the property set name, so PSET wall common in our case, then a tab followed by the IFC property name. In this case, we'll take the compartmentation. And I would also recommend you to copy these names from the IFC documentation because if you mistype them, the mapping table won't work. And last but not least, you enter one last tab and then type the name of your Revit property. We can of course enter as many properties as we need in our text file and also store it on a network drive so we can easily use it throughout all the projects. One thing you should also take care of is to follow the syntax and only use the tabs between your entries and also verify that your text editor saves the file in the UTF-8 format. Once we have set the file up, we can go ahead, select it in the export dialog and check the results. As you can see here, the values have been mapped correctly. As mentioned at the beginning, the common property sets are the universal way to describe information attached to your IFC objects, and you should be using them whenever possible. Only if you want to attach specific information which is not defined in the IFC schema, you should go ahead and create your own property sets. We will have a closer look at this in the next video. Until then, thanks for watching, and don't forget to leave any questions or feedback in the comment section below.